Three, two, one. Hi, this is Robert Friedman. Today we're doing another episode in the continuing story of what we call the Teaneck experience. Today it's a privilege and an honor to be in Dumbo, which is a section of downtown Brooklyn situated between the Brooklyn and Manhattan bridges, and I'm standing inside the creation which is called Jane's Carousel, which was exclusively put together by a former classmate who graduated Teaneck High School in 1962, Jane Zimmerman Walentas, who it's a pleasure to be with today. And sitting with her is the chairman of the 50th class reunion for the graduating class of Teaneck High 1962. And basically our purpose is to take a walk back through time a little bit, go down memory lane and talk about what the Teaneck experience means and what was it about living and growing up in Teaneck that formed the future careers and professions of people. What was it about this town that made it so special in what we call basically during the 1950s and the 1960s, the golden era of Teaneck. So Richie, why don't you start off?
Okay, thanks, Marilyn. First of all, I gotta say, tremendous pleasure it is to be here. Thanks. Seeing you one a number of years and to see what you've created. And
thanks.
I also have to say that it doesn't surprise me that you had this in you, as I remember you as a very bright and talented person with great passion, and you can see every bit of that here. It's just beautiful. You've done so much for this part of the city.
Thanks. Thanks for coming. It's a trip.
So I guess we can talk a little bit about what got you here and how you, whether you have any thoughts about your childhood growing up in Teaneck and how that helped form, you know, some of your thoughts and your travels and your life.
Yeah, definitely. You know, when I knew you were coming, I really started thinking seriously about how Teaneck impacted all of this. First of all, I remember we were talking about what grammar school I went to. I guess it was Lowell School, is that what I decided?
I went to Lowell. I think you decided.
Longfellow or Lowell?
No, Washington Irving.
Washington.
Oh no, Longfellow is where I went. Anyway, I was the kid whose drawings were always up in the principal's office. You know, we'd do our little drawings first, second grade, and sorry, there's a scissor lift
that's okay
going around out there. So I guess I was encouraged from a very early age to draw. At that time, I think I wanted to work for Walt Disney because that's what we knew about, was Walt Disney. And then, I don't know, I don't remember adolescence that well, you know, kind of fast forward to high school, because who remembers when they were 10, 11, or not? I don't think anyone's remembers. But, and first of all, going to Palisades Park, certainly I had a love for the amusement park and a love for carousels. And, but I remember, and I wish I still had it, we produced Carousel. And it's just, I mean, it's an irony. I don't say that's how I got involved in this.
We were talking about that last week.
John Brancato.
Yeah. And Carousel. I have the playbill.
Carousel, and my then boyfriend Jeff was, I think he was the director of it.
I think so.
Yeah, and I did the sets, and I did the program. I don't have that program.
I have one, I'll get it to you.
I certainly know every word from the score still. You know, but that was really
so there was a special place in your heart.
That's okay. It was work in progress, but we make progress too.
Yeah, the
go right ahead.
Is closed Tuesday, so
that's okay.
An opportunity for us to get our maintenance done.